anything that you feel that you think could be, you know, something that's cancerous, just go have it checked, you know, and if it's not, good, but at least you know. And then if you do go and you catch it early enough, then you're fortunate enough to not have to worry about, you know, chemo, radiation, and a lot of the other things that come with it.
Well, screening mammograms are done in asymptomatic women. No new palpable lumps, no skin changes, nothing that's clinically concerning. A diagnostic mammogram is generated either from a screening mammogram, which may have an abnormal finding that needs additional workup with additional mammographic views, special spot compression views of the area, magnification views to look for calcifications, and often ultrasound to evaluate any masses detected on the screening mammogram. Diagnostic mammogram is also done for women who do have a palpable lump or other suspicious findings. Callbacks are generated from the screening exam. We're looking for masses. Masses can be benign cysts or other benign tumors. Possibilities are are called asymmetries, which does not meet the definitive characteristics on a mass on mammogram. Maybe you only see them in one view. And these can potentially represent subtle cancers, so that's why we do pay attention to them. But often when we do the additional workup, they turn out to be just kind of normal glandular tissue that has superimposed over itself and looks kind of more mass-like. The asymmetries in particular with the 3D mammograms, tomosynthesis, the callback has decreased on that because you can actually look through and determine better if it is just summation tissue or versus a true mass. Other things that people are called back for calcifications, calcium is very common to find in the breast. The majority of cases are benign, but calcium deposits can sometimes represent the very earliest form of breast cancer, so-called ductal carcinoma in situ when there's no mass, so we do pay attention to those. When we do the diagnostic workup, we're telling the patient right then and there, the radiologist meets with the patient and tells the patient right then and there the results of the diagnostic workup and if they need a biopsy.
Once the biopsy has been done, depending on the pathology, women may be referred to a surgeon because the pathology is indeterminate and those women may require an excisional biopsy in order to clarify the situation, or they may be diagnosed with cancer, which then becomes primarily surgical treatment. Well, we have a comprehensive center for excellence at Certified Breast Center here, so we have a lot of support services available to women that have been diagnosed with breast cancer, not only in terms of treatment, which is certainly comprehensive and up to date here in terms of all different types of treatment for breast cancer, but we also have nurse navigators that can help you get appointments.
I step in once a woman is diagnosed with breast cancer. So I am available at that time to ensure that they get the appropriate referrals, to ensure that once they've met with their physician that they understand their plan of care, and again to identify any barriers that might impede their plan of care, either logistics, getting to and from treatment, ensuring that they have support if they need to miss work during their treatment. There's all kinds of different needs that are individual, and I can step in and identify those and find the appropriate resources.
I found it, and then I had DCIS. It's a high-grade DCIS. It's non-invasive, so it doesn't spread. They just removed it and removed all the tissue and everything, and because they were able to get it all, because it hadn't spread, I didn't have to do the chemo. I only had the cancer in one in the left breast, and so I chose to take them both because I didn't want to be uneven. And so I just said, take it, then I don't have to worry about it. Eliminated any possibility of cancer coming back. I have young children and I just don't want to have to worry about my health that way. So I just chose to eliminate that risk altogether.